It's been 10 years since the lives of the neighbors here on Randall Street in Waterbury were turned upside down.
You know, it's certainly something that sticks with you and sort of haunts you in a way.
Homeowner Roger Clapp is haunted by the memory of Tropical Storm Irene, which destroyed much of central and southern Vermont on August 28th, 2011.
No one really predicted that Irene was going to come and sit and dump 10 inches of rain here. And, you know, we didn't have much more than an hour's warning before my wife and kids had to flee.
His family left their home as floodwaters rushed in, claiming the entire first floor.
It was devastating. Fortunately, a tremendous number of volunteers came in and pitched in. Even just the next day, people were here helping to move out the wreckage.
The wreckage spanning across neighborhoods, the floodwaters knowing no bounds.
The street was full of appliances and just stuff.
The town paying $150,000 to haul away dumpsters full of trash, furniture, and memories, all destroyed by Irene.
I just remember being exhausted.
It's a memory that sits with Waterbury Town Manager Bill Shepelek.
It's a seminal moment in the history of the community, and certainly for me, you know, it is a big reference point. You know, you kind of post Irene, and compared to what life was here before Irene, it's been very different.
The town has been completely transformed. What Irene took away has been replaced. There's a new state office complex, a new town hall, new homes, and new infrastructure.
Really an amazing time period.
At the time, Barb Farr was in charge of managing local roads that were damaged throughout the state.
I think the big thing was to identify the very first thing out of the gate was which roads are damaged and are they too critical resources.
The state making road and bridge repairs a top priority.
The idea to be more resilient, it's really about bouncing back and getting the system up and running as soon as possible.
The Vermont Agency of Transportation using Irene as an opportunity to grow and adapt. Now it's more prepared than ever to respond to emergencies by launching an incident command system.
We're able to mobilize quickly and respond quickly and deal with the most critical life safety issues as fast as possible. So that's really important because we can't fix everything ahead of time. And so we need to be able to respond quickly.
VTrans also started a vulnerability assessment for every road, bridge, and culvert in the state. And when those need to be rebuilt, they're becoming more innovative.
We're designing our infrastructure, particularly roads and bridges, so that they work more in harmony with the rivers that they're crossing.
Through the destruction, Vermonters learned a thing or two from Irene, like the importance of lending and accepting a helping hand.
Personally, I'm grateful for that event. I'm grateful for what I was able to see in my neighbors and my community and changed things in my life because of it.
After the storm, Waterbury resident Whitney Aldridge was able to open up Axel's Frame Shop and Gallery downtown.
I think as we grow as a society and we grow as individuals, it's important to remember all of those milestones that gave you the opportunity to grow. And Irene is one of those times.
She's been so touched by the outpouring of community support that she's worked with Waterbury Arts to commission this mural, a phoenix rising from the ashes, to commemorate the 10th anniversary of Tropical Storm Irene. Donors raised close to $50,000 to make it happen.
I think that it's a perfect symbol for our community.
Aldridge is taking the commemoration a step further by showcasing community artwork created in the immediate aftermath of the flood in an exhibit called After Irene, the Floodgates Art Project. It's a reminder of all this community has been through.
I kind of somewhat feel badly saying that I'm glad that Tropical Storm Irene happened, but for me personally, there were some really great changes that it afforded me to make.
Through good times and bad.
We figured out how to deal with the hand that we were dealt. I think we played it pretty well in retrospect.
And I think here in Waterbury, just the timing of Irene and when that happened, and then all the other projects that we've been going through here, Waterbury is ending up in a pretty good spot.
Waterbury has certainly come out on the other side.
In many ways, the place is better than it ever has been.
Clapp's wooden floors make his home look and feel good as new.
Yeah, it was really remarkable, and we're certainly remain forever thankful.
He's thankful to those who helped him rebuild a decade ago. And though Irene may have taken a lot away from a lot of people, it didn't wash away this community spirit. In Waterbury, Liz Streppa, NBC5 News.